What's up, guys? My name is Cascavel, also known as Tank. I'm going to teach you how to use Blender by modding GTA San Andreas skins. Now, you're probably watching this video because you want to mod your game, and you probably don't want to spend too much time learning Blender, but I assure you that it is fundamental that you know a couple of things before we do anything complex. So I'm just going to teach you the controls, a bit of the interface. It's not going to take too long. And on this video, I will teach you how to do a simple head swap. For this, you need GTA San Andreas, Blender, and an add-on that you can find at github.com. It was made by Peric27. I hope I didn't butcher that name. But basically, this add-on lets Blender read DFF files. It also features a couple of other stuff like collision files, map files, UV maps, etc., etc. So if you want to use Blender, you definitely need this add-on. You just go to the releases tab. I got this one. You just download this zip file. Go to Blender file. Edit preferences, and then you click install, and then you pick out the zip you just downloaded. It's very important that you do not import an unzip file, otherwise it's not going to work. If you have any issues with this, leave a comment down below and I'll try to help you. Now, once it's installed, it's going to show up here, and you simply need to tick it. Right, this is untick, you just need to tick that. In this case, it should be this import export GTA Dragon FF. And once that's done, you can start modding. Now, you'll probably have a scene similar to this. It probably has a camera and some lights. You can simply delete those, you don't need that. And you do this by just clicking the cube, pressing X, and then clicking delete. So let's import our first models. I'm gonna go to my folder that I set up specifically to do this. So I'm gonna use the Ballast One skin and the BMyCR. I have the DFF file here. Bam, it's imported. Now, one thing that you need to do before you do this, I'm going to assume that you know how to extract files, but this is the way I like to set up my modding folders. I just separate each skin in its individual folder, and then I put the final DFF in the final thing. And you basically, for example, in this folder, you need to have the DFF file, the TXD, and make sure that the PNG file is extracted. Otherwise, it's not gonna import the skin with the texture, and then it's just a waste of time to individually assign the textures. Now, you might be thinking, well, it's white, so it didn't really import any textures, did it? Well, that's not true. It's just the way that the viewport shading is shading it. Right now it's the solid viewport shading. You need to be using the material preview, right? There you go. If you did not have this PNG here, it would show up purple most likely. And you need to, you know, click this, go to the material editor, import the material like so, and then assign it. This is especially time consuming if it's a skin with like five different textures, so it's just better if you do it this way. Now, to move around like this, you can see I'm using the middle mouse button. I got my keys here, so it's easier for you to follow along. And you can also use shift mouse click to move around like this. And this is pretty much the way that I move around the viewport. It's also very important that you use orthographic mode, and you'll see why in a second. I like to, as you can see, the model is not rotated, but I'm gonna do that right now. I like to use the front orthographic, and I'm gonna tell this guy to face me. So I basically press R, then I type in minus 90, right? You can use the mouse, okay? But if you use the mouse, you'll probably like misalign the skin, and this is an issue when you're head swapping, because you might, you know, do a poor job because it's not aligned, right? So it's better if you just use orthographic mode, because it's centered, it's like a good camera to use. And then I'm going to rotate it for it to face me. So I press R, and then I press Z, and then I type in 180. And this, the reason why I press Z is because it rotated along the global Z axis, right? And I could just like press X and it rotate on the X axis or the Y axis. But in this case, I want to use the Z axis. Now I want to move the skin a bit to the left or the right, doesn't matter. And there we go. Now I'm going to import the other skin. I did the same procedure as I did in the Ballas one. It has a DFF file and all the textures it needs. I'm going to do the same thing. And bam. So in this video, I suggest that you follow along if you never use Blender. Just get these two skins because they have the same body, and head swapping is really, really easy. So I'm gonna get this guy's head and put it on this guy's body. So I'm gonna work with this skin. I'm gonna press tab to go into edit mode, and I'm gonna press 3. Now you might be seeing these lines, these blue lines, and they kind of make it hard to see what you're doing. So you just go on overlays and you click sharp and they're gone. You could also clear them, but I don't think that's a good idea. Let's just leave them there, but hide them. I might teach you later what these do. But for now, we're just going to focus on head swapping. So I'm going to select, after going on face selection, because you have vertices, these are vertices, then you have edges. You can select multiple edges, vertices, or faces by pressing shift left mouse button. And then you have face selection. I'm going to use face selection to select the head. You know, it's very simple, just shift click, move around with the middle mouse button, making sure you get everything. There we go. Now this guy has a bandana. You can press control. For example, if I selected these by mistake, press control left click to clear them. Now this guy has a bandana, so it's better to go on wireframe mode. Make sure that you selected everything. And there you go. Very simple. Now, after selecting the head, you just press P, separate by selection, press tab, click the head, press G, X, and bam. Now for this tutorial, I'm not gonna need this body, so I can just delete it. And also don't need it, the root, so I can delete that. The root is basically the rig. That's what animates the mesh. This is a mesh, this is also a mesh. And you have the rig. Now, you don't need to see that while you're modeling, so you can just click this little eye icon. Now it's hidden. I didn't delete it. You should never delete the rig. Just hide from the viewport. Now I got this little floating head, so I'm gonna remove this guy's body. So I'm gonna do the same thing. Just tab, just select this guy's head, Gonna make sure that I didn't miss any spots. I did miss some. Now I'm just gonna press X, delete faces. Oh, looks like I did miss something. And there we go. Orthographic, X. Looks pretty much aligned. See, since it's the same body, like it's pretty seamless transition. So that's why I picked these two skins, because they're just easy. If you're a beginner, it's very easy to just follow along, not get frustrated with things. But not that's not all done. Now you need to select the head. Press shift, click the body, and do control join. And now the head is attached to the body. Now you click, press tab, press 1. Now you might not see, but there's two vertices here. One from the head and one from the body. You need to merge them by doing Alt M at center. We're just gonna do this all around the neck. Now, very simple. There's nothing hard about this. You can go inside the head. In this case, we have a chain that kind of makes our job difficult. But you can just go inside and get all the vertices. And it's easy peasy. I think I got that one already, but whatever. And there you go. Now, it's pretty much done. The head swap is done. It's really simple, right? Nothing difficult, I hope. I hope you followed along. If not, I hope you try it later, because this is really not hard to mod skins on San Andreas. It's really simple. Now, you want to go to the material properties before you export this model. And as you can see, you have the neck cross texture. This is what's applying the texture to this necklace and this thing on the wrist. Then you have the skin that's texturing the body, and the head texture that's texturing the head. Now, I don't know if the add-on, if I'm using an old version or not, but the materials are not named. But for good practice, I like to name them. You don't need to do this. This is not mandatory, but I like to keep things organized, especially when I'm working with a lot of textures. But the thing that you have to do before you move along is go through each individual material, go to ambient shading, make sure the value of the color is set to 1, because if it's set to lower than 1, when you go in game, the skin is gonna be darker, like the head or whatever material you're selecting. It's gonna be darker. You don't see it in Blender, but it's gonna be darker. I spent an entire afternoon trying to figure out why my skin was darker, and it was just this value. Sometimes it's lower than 1 for some reason. So make sure that's set to 1. These skins are all set to 1 already. I don't know if it's a San Andreas thing or if it was just a mod that for some reason has this value lower than 1. But yeah. Also, go to surface. Make sure the specular on all materials is set to 0. If it's set to 0.5, it looks like the mobile version skins. So just set that to 0. I think the roughness can be at 1. I've never had any issues with that. But don't take my word for it. So once that's all done, we're gonna go to File, Export, drag in DFF. We're gonna go back to that folder that I made specifically for this mod, San Andreas Tutorial Final. Okay, I'm just gonna type in bolus 1, drag in DFF, Boom. And it's done. I'm gonna go to my balance folder. I'm gonna copy and paste the TXT file that I have, the vanilla one. I'm gonna open this with Magic TXT. You could be using TXT Workshop, but I personally prefer Magic TXT. And now you need to make sure that the neck cross and the body texture are here. Otherwise in game, they're gonna be white. So you just go to the other folder. Then you add this one. File, save. Now let's go in game and see how the mod's doing.